Welcome. This is take two for Is It Depression or Is It Burnout? Facebook deleted my live. So this time I am recording it and they cannot delete it. So anyway, I hope this one's better than the first one, but I'm Dr. Erin Wiseman coming at you. I am a physician, mother of three, athlete, and physician life coach. I particularly specialize in work-life balance and burnout because those are two huge issues that I felt like I have been going through my medical career, and I want to help other like-minded fierce female physicians also go through it. So I'm so glad that you're viewing today, and let's jump into this topic. Why I bring it up is because in 2014, I was a burned out physician and I didn't even realize it. Of course, I had taken the PHQ-9 and, you know, done all my assessments and thought, am I really depressed? Is that really what's going on with me? But the more as I started networking and talking with other physicians about how I felt, the more and more I realized it wasn't mental health support that I needed for depression. It was actually burnout support that I needed because of our career path. So with that being said, I think it's really important to understand the difference between depression and burnout. Now, you can go get like the formal definitions on the website, or I have a new ebook that you can download and read those in there. But let me tell you my definitions. So when I think of depression, I think of a cup that can just not get full. No matter what, the cup is always less than half full. It's always more than half empty. These people, I feel like no matter what their world is around them, for some reason that cup cannot get full. You know, many times as a family medicine doc, I'm always talking with people about seeking out counseling and therapy along with medications. And a lot of times that's what it takes to break through a depressive cycle. But the difference between burnout and depression is where that cup is not full in depression, the cup in burnout is cracked. You keep putting as much in as you possibly can, trying to fill your cup, trying to find fulfillment and happiness. But that burnout has cracked your cup. And I remember when I was in the middle of burnout, that's essentially what I felt like. I told my husband, my soul feels broken. And that's what really made me go on a search and say, life cannot stay like this. It has to get better. It has to be different. And that is my why I now help other people who are experiencing burnout. Because that brokenness, that crack in your cup, it can be repaired. And your cup can be full and life can be wonderful again. Now, it's going to take some work. It takes some soul searching. It takes some changes. But it definitely can happen. So let me talk a little bit about maybe you are in burnout. And here are my for instances. Again, I'm not going to go to the formal definition of like depersonalization, the lack of self-achievement, blah, blah, blah. We're not going to even go into that. Instead of what we're going to go into is symptoms that I personally have felt and the people I work with have felt. So the first one is what I call the Sunday dreads. This is, you've been off call all weekend, you haven't been into the office, you haven't even opened your computer to do notes, but just kind of all of a sudden, that day before work, you start to feel it. And I know for me, where I felt it was in my chest. It was just kind of like a heaviness that would then lead to like anxiety, or it would lead to fatigue, like I needed to go lay down and take a nap at 5 o'clock, or it would come on as a headache. Other people I talked to, one particular colleague, she was like, every day that I drove into the office, I just started getting like myalgias and muscle aches. And she's like, I was taking Tylenol because I thought something was going on with me. But then she realized it wasn't the drive. It wasn't the early morning because she was fine other mornings when she wasn't going to work. It was that anticipation, that Sunday dread, that Monday morning dread that she was feeling as she was driving into work. So do you have that? Do you have just these kind of like weird things that as you start to think about your next work day, or you're coming off of a long weekend, or maybe you're on vacation and thinking about going back into the office, and all of a sudden something hits you, like a black cloud or a weight or just a turmoil of emotions inside of you. That is a clear indicator that you have some burnout in your life. The second one I want to talk about is what I call detachment. So I remember sitting in my exam room talking to a patient, and she was telling me what was going on in her life and that she was having like some depressive anxiety symptoms. And my detachment as I sat there was, you really think this is that bad? my life is so much worse than this. Wow. Another form of detachment that I had when I was in burnout was one of my colleagues was diagnosed with breast cancer, stage 3 breast cancer. And, you know, instead of the first thought being empathy or like, oh my gosh, shock, do you want to know what my first thought was? It just appalls me even now to say it, but it's truth, is that I thought, well, at least she doesn't have to keep going back to her office. What was I was in such a bad place that that was my first thought, was that she didn't have to return to the practice of medicine because of where I was at. God, she had cancer. What was I thinking? But that's what burnout does to you. It cracks you to the core that you are not functioning well. You're not even in the right place to be functioning well. And we'll get into a little more about why that is. But the third thing that I want to bring up, and what I just mentioned, is that broken feeling. I cannot tell you how many times I talk to colleagues, I talk to other women who are in medicine or even in just in business in general, and they say, when I start telling my burnout story and I tell them, most of the time they say, I felt broken. And why this is because we're now recognizing burnout more as a spiritual brokenness, a moral distress syndrome. We're equating it more to like soldiers of war coming back with PTSD. We have this intention of medicine that we are going to help and we are going to heal and we are going to change lives. And then we get out into the battlefield, we get into the hospitals, the wards, the clinics, and it is not like that at all. We're struggling through our day with paperwork. We're doing EMRs. We're doing all these things that don't come back to our calling. We're not taking care of people. We're taking care of paperwork or computers. We're not touching people because we're caught in meetings. We're sleep deprived because we're doing so much charting. So there's a huge disconnect that your heart went into medicine or went into whatever your career path is because you wanted to help people. But your job keeps you from doing it. So you're struggling back and forth, and that's where that sense of splitting and brokenness comes from. So if you have that feeling, like, yeah, something deep inside of me is a little bit broken, you're not the only one, and that is a clear, clear sign of burnout. So burnout is two parts. I break it down this way because I feel like that's the best way to then heal from it. So the first part is the internal part. That's our thoughts, emotions, feelings, our actions, and our patterns of behavior that what we do. Those are the things that coaching is really great at working at. We can work on that self-improvement environment. But here's the other side of burnout. It's the external environment. That's healthcare as a whole. That's the culture that we live and work in as healthcare providers, where they say the patient comes first. You haven't peed in 12 hours, too bad. You need to go take care of it. No, you can't have a sick day off. There's other sick patients you need to take care of. If you talk about your feelings, you talk about being burned out, it's looked more critically as a failure or a weakness rather than being vulnerable and authentic and showing up with how you are. So the external environment of healthcare is a huge reason for burnout. And that's why I say burnout is not a personal feeling. You cannot yoga, you cannot mindfulness, you cannot meditate your way out of burnout. We have got to change healthcare. And that's why I am so vocal and verbal about saying we must change the culture of healthcare. But so while I do individual coaching and group coaching and lots of groups and materials on the internal environment, I'm also working really hard on the external environment, speaking to anybody who will listen to me, going to as many events as possible, lobbying with my state association to get non-competes out of the state and also get mental health resources opened up to physicians so it's not penalties on us to do it. So we keep churning and burning on the internal side, and we keep making changes on the external side, which leads me to my message to you. One, you are not broken. Burnout is not a personal failing. It is the result of a system in which you're operating in, and you have gotten to a point that your why doesn't match your work. And so that's one area that I can definitely help you with. Two, Again, you are not a failure if you admit that you are burned out. Because if you are and you stay where you're at, you are not going to be functional. Instead, you are looking for forward thinking and getting better out of this situation. So do not feel like you're a failure to admit that saying, hey, there's a problem and I want a solution. Because you know what? You are one of the most intelligent people that this earth has to offer. As a physician, I've always been above average. So why would I not want to be above average in my own self-care? So by reaching out, that's showing that you're above average. Number three, change is possible. Where you are at today does not have to stay your reality forever. And actually, it won't stay your reality. If you don't change, if you stay where you're at, that's an intentional choice. So let's make the choice to make life better for you. And number four is you don't have to quit your job. You don't have to divorce your spouse. You don't have to move states. You don't have to get more training or go back to residency to make life better. Now, maybe when you get down the road, you see that you need to make some big changes. So what? You're going to be prepared for it. It only starts with one single step. One thing moving forward to make life better. One thing to show that you can control your life and your environment. Because so much of burnout is related to feeling like you're out of control. So with that one step, I want you to know that I see you and I want to help you. And I want to help you move forward in the direction of your best life possible. And the only way that I can do that is to talk to you. I can't read minds. I can't even get full messages through Facebook. I need to talk with people. So I have these opportunities where you can set up and talk to me confidentially, 100% confident. Let me tell you about it. So it's in an environment we can talk over the phone. We can talk over the internet, but it's 100% free. I 100% understand where you're coming from. It's 100% confidential. In no way do I report to any hospitals, any licensing boards, anything like that. And I 100% believe in you. So let me leave you with this quote because I think it's so important. Your happiness may in fact have nothing to do with balance, but much rather with finding the life you love and the courage to live in it. That's absolutely true. Absolutely true. So how can you get more help besides the phone call that I mentioned? There's a free ebook that goes right along with this topic. Is it depression or is it burnout? You can get those links and definitely get to it and share it with as many people as you want. I gotta fly. Because that's what I want. I want to help as many people possible. Second thing you can do is sign up for my new newsletter. I'm going to be sending a newsletter out every Sunday called Sunday Sunshine. And what its purpose is to dispel those Sunday dreads that you feel, to give you a tip moving forward into the week, on how you can improve your life, your family, and your practice. Because you know what? All of those are so very important. The third way that you can do is I have a new group starting. It's called Mother Doctor Badass, and it is all about work-life balance. Now, of course, I don't really believe that there's ever a true balance point that you hold that's static. I think life is always very fluid, but it's learning to make the decisions on what is in your life, what do you want to keep in your life, and what do you need to get rid of because it is not bringing you joy and it's not bringing you the balance you want. So jump into that Facebook group. Again, it's called Mother Doctor Badass. The fourth thing you can do is look out for some more retreats. So I have one in September that is sold out. We're getting ready to do here in a few weeks. But I will also have a spring one. I'm thinking, I don't know what time. We'll have to just see what the weather looks like. But this spring, and then I will also do another outdoor retreat in the fall. So spring and a fall retreat. But then also in May, we are doing Mom Vacay 2019. So these are for mothers who are ready to get away and to take some time to do some self-reflection, to get some coaching every day, to get some yoga, get some beach time. Yes. In a beautiful location, and it is going to be exclusively just to a handful of women, and I will be releasing more dates. We are going south, and it is going to be beautiful. So Mom Vacay 2019, start looking for details for that in the next couple of weeks. And the last thing is, if you are in healthcare, I specifically made a handbook called Doctor Me First. It's for you. You can do it self-paced where you work through it, and it helps you work through where you're at in life and through burnout. There's a group option with it, which that's actually starting September 4th. And I am super excited to get that going. It's going to be a group of us women in healthcare who are going to be working through that manual together in a group setting so that we can support each other and move forward. And then there's also a one-on-one package that I work specifically with physicians in burnout very intensively to get them to a life that they love. So a lot of different options. I am here for you. I see you, and I have got your back. Send me any messages or anybody who needs me my direction. Thanks, guys.